Welcome to Hell's Down Under. Playing around a little bit tonight. Cocktail recipes. Cocktail night in the lounge. I've been joined by Jimbo. Jimbo, why don't you say hi to your fans? Jimbo, where are you from? If Jimbo could talk. So we're playing around with some peanut butter and chocolate cocktails tonight, because why not? Sounds like a good idea. A screwball, which the people like it. People will drink it straight, but if you put that over ice, that'd be really good. De Kuypers also has peanut butter liqueur. Holy crap, this is some old peanut butter whiskey. I'm guessing this is just gonna be sweet. It's a little thinner. I like the peanut butter smell of the screwball. Okay, that's just like peanut brittle. I love peanut brittle. That's gonna be interesting in some cocktails. The other things up here are chocolate. This is creme de cacao, but this is a dark creme de cacao, also from De Kuypers, also since 1695. It's suspicious that they're both from the same year. But it says right here, this is the brand that bartenders trust. I'm gonna take Ronald Reagan's advice, trust but verify. It's not strongly flavored to anything. And then they also have creme de cacao that is light colored. This is virtually clear. But this brand is Boucher, Liqueur du Boucher. Right on the back, contains caramel color. All right, that's weird. It's a really faint taste. All right, then we have the Godiva chocolate liqueur, and this is a dark chocolate. I've used this in other chocolate-based things, like a chocolate martini. I get a little hint of that, like a Hershey's chocolate syrup, but not real strongly. You know, it's interesting, when I was a kid, I loved to get chocolate milk. We always had milk delivered to the house from the local dairy, and I could pour that chocolate syrup in there. If mom wasn't watching, woo, maybe the chocolate syrup went in there. But it was almost, it didn't matter how much you stirred it up, you still had a layer of chocolate syrup that just kind of settled out to the bottom. That's what that is. It's not quite as strongly chocolate as that old Hershey syrup was, but it's not bad. And then this is the Godiva, their regular chocolate liqueur, which is basically a milk chocolate, and this is creamy. Okay, that's just like thin chocolate milk. So equal parts, peanut butter whiskey. So we're doing screwball on this one. And I'm gonna go with the De Kuypers dark in this. It's not bad. Probably should have did like the Godiva dark, but. And then this one actually, you would do a 1/2 ounce bourbon. I'm gonna go with the Wild Turkey 101 just because this is so weak alcohol wise that I want a little bit of stout backbone in this, so we'll just do 1/2 a shot. We'll stir that up. You're paying attention over here because chocolate peanut butter bourbon shot. Can't say that I really can pick out the chocolate or the peanut butter or the bourbon. I'm a little surprised by that. I might have to do a little bit of a different one here. This is a moment of indecision, folks. How old are you anyway? Let's start over. We're gonna try a different cocktail here, and I think we're gonna try a couple different variations on things, a little mix and match of different liqueurs over here. So this is gonna start out with an ounce of, I'm gonna do an ounce of the De Kuypers peanut butter to start with. We'll do that one first. Let's get some ice in our little ice in the mixing glass. All right, and I get some De Kuypers going in here. We want 1 ounce. Then we want 1/2 ounce of our chocolate liqueur, this guy. So we're doing the De Kuypers and the De Boucher, not French. So a little bit of chocolate in that, and 1.5 ounces. And I'm gonna go with the Wild Turkey, or as my wife would call it, the turkey whiskey. I want 1.5 ounces of this, and I want a shot of bitters. I'm just going to do one nice healthy shot. I love the smell of this stuff. Man, so have you ever smelled this? This is good stuff. You should try it sometime. I know. Probably won't like it. All right, so stir, stir, stir. Get it nice and cold. And we're going to pour it into our serving glass. Now that's a nice looking drink because we worked with the light creme de cacao, but there's only half an ounce in here, so not going to be a lot of chocolate influence. That's not really flipping my lid. Cut. That's not an all-star that I would put on my menu. I'm going to try just to add a couple drips of Bitterman's chocolate mole, chocolate bitters. Okay, that is 5 tiny drips in there. Ooh, that turned up the chocolate though. Wow. Oh, I love the smell on that. Those chocolate bitters on there, they really turned that up a little bit. That's not bad. That's not bad. For somebody that wants something that is not overpowering, you don't taste the bourbon in this at all. You got 1.5 ounces of Wild Turkey 101, you don't taste it at all. I forgot that it was there. Man, you smell that, you get a little bit of cinnamon toast on that. Boy, did I love cinnamon toast. And I don't eat a lot of carbs anymore lately, but dang, do I miss... I hadn't even thought about that. A cinnamon toast, man. I used to eat that stuff. Okay, that's an interesting turn of... Okay. All right, we can go with that. That's not bad. That's with the De Kuyper's peanut butter and the De Boucher creme de cacao, which is kind of muted. It's only 15% alcohol versus the De Kuyper's is, I think, 24%, as I recall. So this is pretty muted. It does have caramel coloring, though. You say so. But man, 1.5 ounces of Wild Turkey in there, and you don't even notice it. You don't even notice it. Do you notice it? Yeah, I didn't think so. All right, let's try that again, a little different variety. Let's go with the Screwball because, well, I really think the Screwball is going to end up being the star of the show. What I'm going to do with the rest of this stuff, I don't know. But I think we're going to go with the Screwball and the Godiva Dark. It's going to make the drink a lot darker, and I may not need the chocolate bitters. And we're going to try the Old Forester bourbon in this. I may have to make it again with the Wild Turkey because, well, yeah, the bourbon's not overpowering at all. All right, so let's go back here. Screwball, 1 ounce. All right, 1 ounce of Screwball, 1/2 ounce. Of Godiva Dark. Oh, I can smell that already. Man, I like the smell of that. That's got that Hershey's chocolate syrup. Man, that's good stuff. All right, now I need 1.5 ounces of bourbon. I'm gonna go with the Old Forester on this one. It's a little bit of a heavy 1.5 ounces, I have to admit. And we'll go with a shot, 1 dash of Angostura bitters. Oh, I love the smell of that stuff. Oh. That's where that cinnamon was coming on the other one. You need a dash of that and you need the chocolate bitters. That is a completely different drink. All right, take 3 of the peanut butter whiskey cocktail. All right, for this one, we're gonna stick with the Screwball. I'm going to try the De Kuyper's on this and the Wild Turkey 101. So I need 1 ounce of Screwball. Feels like I've been down this path before. kind of like these little speed pours out of here. It's not that I'm trying to pour fast, but that makes it easier, much easier to pour and control the pour. That's really not bad. All right, and then I need a 1/2 ounce of the chocolate liqueur, creme de cacao. Oh, my French co-workers, they're going to be proud of me. Crème de cacao? I don't know, maybe. And then I need 1.5 ounces, and the 1.5 ounces is going to be wild turkey. Good thing I'm not drinking all of them. Are you drinking any of these? Because if I drink all of this, I'm going to be gone. All right, and we're going to give a nice heavy dash of Angostura. And we give it a stir. All right, good stuff. Good times. All right. This in the serving glass. This is definitely the kind of thing that, I don't know, this would appeal to the ladies, I guess. All right, now that's slightly darker, but only slightly. I'm guessing that, see, this has got the Godiva dark in it, and this has got the De Kuyper's dark in there. And it's the wild turkey bourbon. Peanut butter definitely stands out a little better in that. You really don't notice the bourbon. That's not bad. Yeah, that's not bad. All right, let's do our little Bitterman's in here. In the serving glass. 5 drips. Sits right up on top. Man, does that smell good. That is the key. You make this, you want to add those chocolate bitters at the end after it's in the serving glass. You taking notes on this? Yeah, those chocolate bitters at the end are really good. They mix well with the Angostura bitters in the drink. The Angostura bitters gives it, the Angostura bitters kind of edge on it, which is a nice spicy, like allspice and nutmeg and some cinnamon maybe, but not too much cinnamon in there. It's like the Christmas spices in there. I don't know how to explain the Angostura aromatic bitters, but man, when you put the Bitterman's chocolate bitters on top of that, that's the key. That's the linchpin on that. The linchpin is the Bitterman's in the serving glass at the end. That's going to be how it gets presented, and that's how it's going to be really, really well liked. I said that this reminded me of, cinnamon toast as a kid, and I remembered, the Hershey syrup as a kid. Are all your best memories from when you were a kid? Man. Okay, so let's try this. Let's go back to the beginning. I don't even remember what was in this. I still smell the chocolate bitters on that. But that just tastes candy. That tastes sweet. It's like, eh. It's okay. I mean, if you were served that in a restaurant, you would probably... No, you can't have that in a restaurant. You're not. Didn't we already discuss your age? All right, so this was kind of, let's go with the cheap. It smells good, but it's the Bitterman's. This is our original combination of cacao, cinnamon, and spice that is known as chocolate mentol. Well, that had the Old Forester in it, and that Old Forester is a little overpowering in that. And I gotta tell you, I'm a little shocked at how smooth the Wild Turkey is in these things. Wow. But the key, if I didn't mention it before, the Bitterman's chocolate bitters, that's, wow. I sound a little bit like a fanboy, is that what you're trying to say? Good night, Moon. All right, time to clean up.